Apostle Joseph Ayobabalola, one of the early progenitors of the revival fire that swept through Nigeria and the Southwest in the early 30s and 40s. My God, this man was on fire for God. There was not so much noise and razzmatazz with his bell in his hand and a mismatched babariga and shokoto and a pair of sandals standing on a makeshift pulpit. This anointed servant of God strode through this world like a blazing comet. He does not need to scream and shout, yet he was anointed to the teeth and bones. His simplicity and humility is simply enchanting. It was a terror to the kingdom of hell. He put many herbalists of his days out of business and expelled demons who had the forest as their place of domain. It was said at one time that he entered the evil's forest and demons began to run out of the forest. Times without number, they will bring the dead to his meetings and lay them in front of the altar where he ministered. And without getting distracted from his message, the dead will get up and walk from where they have been kept. It was a man who turned the mountains to his prayer gym. And one occasion, it was said, while he was praying, a python crawled over him. And he never cared, only to get up after prayers to discover the python lying dead by his side. It was also recorded that at a time he prayed on a stream. Until today, the stream is still healing people. And it was said that one day a madman stumbled on the stream and was cured of his madness. His life is such an unconventional one. It's a reprimand to many of us. God is seeking for men who he can invest his unction to trigger another flame of revival in this deprived world. In this world where we have so many organizers but few agonizers, we have so many speakers but few prayer warriors, it is time for men and women to arise. Men that will seek God until the Lord light us up, until we become revival vessels in this our generation. Men like Apostle Ayobabalola must arise again. Prophets must arise that we carry the fire of God. It is time for men to set our generation on fire. God bless you.